Hello, and today we are with Mr. Juan Samso, who is the General Manager of the Ritz-Carlton in Macau. Good afternoon to you, Juan.
Good afternoon. How are you doing today?
I'm very well, thank you. Now, here we are at the Ritz-Carlton in Macau, the very first Ritz-Carlton, in fact, in the country, in the SAR. How is business for you going so far? Because you only opened a little while ago.
We have been open for 4 months already, and the hotel has been extremely successful with occupancies average of 95% so far. So outlets also, Chinese restaurant Lai-in with a good reputation, number one in TripAdvisor, good comments on social media. So definitely the hotel is performing at a high level.
Now, of course, Macau is a destination which is very famous for the casinos. You don't have your own casino here at the Ritz-Carlton. How do you manage to compete with the other properties who've got in-house casino themselves?
We have a casino in the complex. We don't have a casino in the hotel. So it is important that the guests have all the options that you can have in Macau. Macau has casino, Macau has museums, Macau has culture, Macau has all Macau, Macau has Color One. So it's a lot of things to do, shows in Macau apart from only gaming. And definitely Macau is changing a little bit his market into more non-gaming segments.
Now, of course, this is an unusual Ritz-Carlton because you were at the beginning, you were supposed to be the very first all-suite Ritz-Carlton in
Correct.
The world, but then Bali sort of stole that title from you. You are, however, the very first all-suite Ritz-Carlton hotel in a city. Why is this important to the property, and how does it differ from other Ritz-Carltons in the world?
Well, the service is exactly the same, right? So we maintain the values, we maintain the credo, we maintain all who we are as a company. So the service will be exactly the same. Why is important to have an all-suite hotel is that we'll elevate the luxury experience from our customers. We'll make a difference. Our customers nowadays want a space, want luxury, want service, want experiences, and definitely a room like this, the one that you have seen, creates an experience for our customers.
How have you broken up the different suites that you have available here? How do they differ?
We have four kinds of suites. We have the villas, that is going to be the ultra-luxury suites with more than 300 meter squares. You have the Carlton suite with 100 meter squares, and you have then the premier suites with around 80 to 85 meter squares, all with the same structure. You have living room, you have the bedroom, and then you have the bathroom that actually, you know, you can see over there that you can fit a few people in that bathroom.
Ritz-Carlton is also famous for its impeccable and very good high-quality F&B outlets. What F&B outlets do you have here at the hotel?
We have a Lai-in restaurant. It's located on the 51st floor. It's probably a stunning architectural design by a Strickland Japanese designer, and with impeccable level of service. We're doing Cantonese food. The chef is coming from Tin Lung Hing, is our Chinese restaurant to submission in Hong Kong. So he has a history with Hong Kong and with the Cantonese cuisine, but with his personal touch that makes a difference. We have the lounge and bar, extremely famous for gin tonics. So the best gin tonics cocktails in town are located in the lounge and bar. And you have then the Ritz-Carlton Cafe, that is a French brasserie restaurant, casual restaurant connected with the shopping mall. We do lunch, afternoon tea, dinner, afternoon tea with madeleines, with hot chocolates. So that creates a unique experience on the Western cuisine that it was delivered before in Macau.
Food tourism is a growing industry, and it's becoming very popular for hotels to bring in some of the top chefs. Obviously, being Ritz-Carlton, you have access to some of the top chefs in the world. Is this something that you're going to be doing in the future, bringing in Michelin-starred chefs into the hotel to do promotions?
Absolutely. We will do different promotions, obviously, maintaining the concept. So we have Lai-in, that should be a Chinese chef, or should be, you know, Asian-oriented chef. And then you have the Ritz Cafe that will be focused extremely on French chefs. We will also develop, you know, with different submissions that we have also in Ritz-Carlton Hotel Company, like you have in Hong Kong, like you have in Europe, like you have in Japan.
Now, who is staying at this hotel? Because, of course, the Macau as a whole relies very heavily on the mainland Chinese market. But with Ritz-Carlton having such a global name, and also with you having one of the best Ritz-Carltons in the world across the water in Hong Kong, where are your guests currently coming from? Where are the top five markets?
Of course, you know, number one is China. But then number two is Hong Kong. actually from the non-gaming market. Hong Kong is 50% of our room nights. That is very, very strong. And then you have other parts of Asia, like Taiwan, like Japan, like Southeast Asia, right? Because we have a global program for the company that is growing every year and very important in Asia. So our market is growing as we grow on different locations.
In terms of, you mentioned mainland China there, this is a very big issue for obviously the whole industry around the globe. You are in touch with the majority of mainland Chinese guests. How do you manage to maintain that level of service? What are some of the most important aspects in terms of the service that you offer to the mainland Chinese that might differ from other properties elsewhere in the world? That the in terms of the Chinese are looking for, yes.
We always personalize the service. Doesn't matter if it's Chinese, Japanese, Taiwanese, Hong Kongese, Spanish, English. Everybody required has his own style, and we personalize the service to them. So, you know, if you look at the Ritz-Carlton in China, is very well developed. We are in the most important city, so we have a lot of also other ladies and gentlemen coming from other Ritz-Carltons from China that is helping us with the Chinese customers. But we are very used to work with different nationalities and deliver exceptional levels of service.
With so many hotels in Macau and so many hotels opening up in China and elsewhere in the world, choosing the right ladies and gentlemen to work at the Ritz-Carlton is obviously going to be a challenge. How do you manage to maintain that level of service when there is so much competition looking for those impeccable staff?
First of all, our training plan that is a standard for all the company, our countdown process when we open the hotel. We have a very unique way to open hotels with the countdown process. Also, we bring a lot of leaders from other Ritz-Carltons, especially at the beginning, that help the local community to develop the Ritz-Carlton philosophy and our gold standards.
Now, another aspect of the Ritz-Carlton, which is very popular among guests, is the Ritz-Carlton Club. I know the one in Dubai is rather special. Tell us about your Ritz-Carlton Club here and how many Ritz-Carlton Club rooms are available to it?
The whole hotel is all-club hotel. 233 rooms, all club inclusive. The club is located on the 53rd floor, so it's in the top of the building, have two small terraces, and has the main building with the living room. I have a bar, and then I have a kitchen built inside the club. So the key of that club is that everything is personalized. We prepare the food a la minute. You have your personal butler and your personal chef 24 hours in the club preparing the food for you. And that makes a personalized experience for all our customers.
In terms of this, is this part of the package when you're staying at the hotel? It is all inclusive in terms of the food and F&B that you're able to have there?
Correct. We do 5 presentations a day. We do breakfast, lunch, afternoon tea, dinner, and then post dinner. We have open bar, we do cocktails during the evening time, and we always have the chef during all the time periods preparing something for you. So it's like you are at home, right? When you're at home, you are in your living room, you are in the bar, or you are in the dining room area, and the chef is preparing for you the food.
Now, those that don't know Macau very well could be rather confused between what the difference between Cotai and Sands and the Galaxy, for example, are. What is the advantage of being here at the Galaxy when you come to Macau?
Being at the Galaxy complex, that you have the integrated deck at the third floor, you have the lazy river that is incredible for families, great. You have the wave pool, you have probably the best shopping mall that is in Macau and Hong Kong, with luxury brands located exactly on phase 2. You have casinos, you have incredible dining experience, you have Bonban in the building, you got Fog Lamoon, you have Lai Hin, you have the Ritz-Carlton Hong Kong, you have the GW Marriott, you have the Banyan Tree. So that generates that integrated resort that makes a difference between us and our competitors.
Technology, it's something that a lot of hotels are talking about. In terms of the technology that you're using here at the hotel, how far have you pushed it? Are you using keyless, for example, keys? Are you doing self-check-in facilities? How are you using technology to enhance the guest experience?
As a Ritz-Carlton, we have two technologies that we use all the time. One is going to be the mobile check-in, so you can do check-in prior to your arrival from the boat. And also will be the meeting app that we use it for all the meeting planners for MICE groups. So that will be the two platforms that we use for check-in, our guest requires a personal service. Arrival to the hotel, go to 51st floor, give them a glass of champagne, do the registration, and then take them to the room.
Very good. In terms of, for example, some of the other aspects of the property, in terms of the facilities, the spa is obviously a very important thing here. Which spa are you, in terms of the products that you're using in the spa, what are you using? And what makes this spa different from other spas in Macau?
The spa is branded by ESPA, E-S-P-A. That is also very famous around the world, and we use it in different Ritz-Carltons. The journey of the spa, you have a vitality pool and you have a relaxation area that other spas, they don't have it. Normally the experience, you arrive to the spa and you go directly to the treatment room. Here when you arrive, you go to the vitality pool, you go to the relaxation area, and then you go to do your massage or your treatment, right? A spa menu makes a difference between us and others. And actually, we just got awarded by the best design spa in Asia for 2015. So it has been so far for the first 4 months very successful spa.
Well, congratulations on that.
Thank you.
Now, obviously in Macau at the moment, this time, a lot of people are saying that the business is not quite as good as it used to be. And they're talking about revenues in the casinos. They're talking about certain issues as well that might be affecting even further those revenues. You've just opened. So do you think you're a little late to the party, or do you think that the Macau is coming out of this slight dip in revenue?
Basically, the quantity of tourists that has been coming to Macau has decreased only 4%. Basically, in China, only 5% of the Chinese knows Macau. You imagine how many population has Macau, China, and how many people can come to visit Macau. Well, we're opening a hotel with 95% occupancy. How many hotels in the world can open the doors and be on 95% occupancy? And I don't know if I answered you your question on that.
No, you did indeed. You did indeed. So excellent. Well, on that note, I think we have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today, Juan. And of course, I wish you and the ladies and gentlemen of the Ritz-Carlton here in Macau the best of luck for the future.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.